For most of the 2010s, ThinkPads had Intel CPUs inside them. This was fine, as AMD CPUs weren't much to rave about, but once they released Ryzen, that all changed. With it quickly outpacing Intel's offerings, it was a no-brainer for Lenovo to make an AMD-based model, with this ThinkPad X395. Hailing from 2019, the X395 wasn't the first AMD-based ThinkPad. That honor belongs to the A275, but it is the first to go with the standard X prefix instead of the A found on previous models, possibly signifying a change of Lenovo's sentiment towards AMD being in their flagship products. And if you're a bit confused by the naming of this ThinkPad, I wouldn't blame you. Traditionally, the X series has a naming scheme of X, 2, generational number, and then 0. So where's this 395 coming from? Well, it's actually a rebrand of sorts. What we have here is a remake of the X280, now with a larger 13-inch screen, so that's where the 3 and the 9 come from. As for the 5, that comes from Lenovo's history of branding their AMD-based laptops like this, such as the A275 or the A285. The X395 launched at a price of £1,069, and for that you would get a Ryzen 3 3300U, 8GB of RAM and a 256GB SSD with a TN panel. Fortunately, my model is a considerable step up from that, with a Ryzen 5 3500U, 16GB of RAM, a 1080p touch display and a 256GB NVMe SSD. Most models will come with a 45W USB-C charger like mine, but it is compatible with up to a 65W charger, so it could come with one like that or a third-party charger. A nice note about the charger is the inside of the USB-C connector being a little throwback to the yellow ThinkPad charging port. For ports, it's a fairly decent showing, with two USB-C ports both able to charge the laptop, an HDMI 2.0 port, a mini Ethernet port for the dock, a headphone jack, a USB 3.0 port with constant power delivery, and a USB 3 10 gigabit port. There is a SIM/microSD card slot around the back, but it's such a pain to get in and out that I couldn't recommend you use it for anything more than expanding the storage size. This is a fairly decent showing, especially compared to modern laptops, but the lack of a full-size SD card slot and a full-size Ethernet slot is a little bit disappointing for a ThinkPad. The keyboard is very similar to most other modern ThinkPads, with a decent amount of travel and nice feel. It has a backlight with three settings that greatly improve visibility during the dark, but are barely visible during most lighting situations. The track point and buttons are here and they're fine. Compared to my old X250 buttons, they have less travel but are still very usable. The trackpad is a big improvement over my X250, being much larger and smoother when sliding your hand across, and it has a lot more gesture control options. For the webcam, there is a 720p camera with a privacy cover built in.
Its performance is fine. Not amazing, but enough for a web call every now and then. The mic is also fine for that, but if you wanted to do any recording, I would recommend you get an external microphone.
The display on this is very nice. It's a 1920x1080 IPS touch display, the highest end option available, and wow. This is one of the nicest displays I have. It has great viewing angles, very decent color reproduction, is very vibrant without feeling oversaturated. I would be very happy to use this for Photoshop or Premiere. Whilst it does have a touchscreen, I don't really make use of it that much, though when I did use it, it was very responsive. One fault with that though, is that it really doesn't look like it has a touch display, so other people trying to point at it may accidentally click something and make you go do something else that you didn't want to do. The bezels on this are also very slim and not distracting at all. The speakers are surprisingly good for a Windows laptop, getting quite loud without sounding too distorted. In terms of build quality, the X395 is outstanding. Being made of a carbon fiber and magnesium alloy, it weighs in at just 1.3 kilograms, but still manages to have little to no flex in daily use. The hinges are firm without feeling stiff and have no wobble when opening the laptop. It does, however, fail the one-handed open test, but I personally don't really care about this. The lid of the laptop is made of the same carbon fiber alloy and feels great. It hides scuffs and scratches quite well at a glance, but look closer and you can see the abuse that the previous owner put this through. on a similar vein to build quality, repairability. ThinkPads are known for their upgradability, but unfortunately, it seems like this is more of a Lenovo laptop than a ThinkPad on this front. With no upgradable RAM, limiting the total amount to 16GB, only one M.2 slot for storage, and no 2.5-inch storage options, I'm a bit let down coming from my X250. Repairability, on the other hand, is actually not bad, needing just 5 captive Phillips head screws and popping of some clips to get under the hood. Unfortunately, there is no removable power connector in case you break the port, though the right-hand USB port is removable. Overall, a rather disappointing showing for upgradability compared to the traditional ThinkPads and things like the Framework laptop, but it does seem that for repairability, it's okay. For network connectivity, I managed to get around 285 down when downloading games off Steam, so plenty fast. Whilst I was doing this, I also discovered that Steam is now transferring games across the local network when available, instead of downloading the files again, so that's pretty cool. The battery life's not bad. My unit has around 130 cycles on it, which isn't bad, and manages to last 4-8 hours of light use with more intense workloads draining it much faster. It also idles very well, not losing a noticeable amount of battery being left in my bag overnight. Definitely something that my X250 could not do. Pricing on the 395 can vary greatly. Mine was £265 shipped to me with a 45 watt charger, and that seems to be in the high end of pricing for similarly spec'd models, costing around £230. Compared to new laptops in the same price range, you're getting a lot better performance and build quality. But it's a fair bit more than some of the other ThinkPads that are available right now, so the choice is really up to you. Coming from the X250, the portability of the 395 is incredible. It's very slim compared to traditional ThinkPads, but nothing compared to the likes of the 12-inch MacBook. It should have no trouble fitting in a case or backpack though. The Ryzen 5 3500U is a fairly formidable CPU, with 4 cores and 8 threads on AMD's Zen Plus architecture. It has a TDP of 15 watts, with a max turbo of 3.7 GHz and a base clock of 2.1 GHz. When it's under a prolonged load of 100%, it settles in at around 2.2 GHz. That doesn't sound too exciting by itself though. The GPU is where it gets really good. Coming with Vega 8 graphics clocked at 1200 MHz, it should actually perform decent in some games or CAD. One thing to note is that when in gaming, or even at 100% load, my model is very quiet, with the fan barely spinning up. This will vary based on how your laptop's been treated in the past. For some quick gaming benchmarks, we have BeamNG, Doom, and CSGO, as well as Cinebench to measure the raw CPU power. Also note that the benchmarks were taken outside the recordings, so the frame rates will vary. BeamNG was run at 720p with a mixture of low and normal settings to achieve an average of bang on 30fps, with 1% lows of 19fps and 0.1% lows of 11fps on the jungle map. It only dropped down to those lows when there was a lot of foliage around, and you could turn down a few of the settings to get up to a 40fps average if you wanted a bit of a smoother gameplay experience. CSGO was run at 1080p at the competitive settings, and managed to get an average of 53fps during an offline bot match, and then 47fps during the community benchmark map. If you're playing an online match, you can expect something more like 60fps, as the CPU has less load by not needing to calculate the bot paths. Doom Eternal was run at 720p low and achieved an average of 29fps, with 1% lows of 21fps and 0.1% lows of 7fps. A fairly decent gaming experience, certainly a lot better than any Intel solutions at the time, or even up till now. For Cinebench R20, it managed to achieve a score of 1,278 points, which puts a fair few hundred points above the much higher power consumption my do much older i5-3550, also doubles the score of the 5200U that was in my old ThinkPad. For productivity, it's quite capable, with it handling large Photoshop projects as well as complex 3D models in Fusion 360 very easily. It also completed renders in Fusion with little complaint. Premiere was fine for basic timelines, but once you started adding a lot of effects, the RAM may start to become a bottleneck. In my video about the X250, a lot of people asked about it for coding. Well, the 395 handles coding fine, as it is just text entry at its core. I didn't do any big compiles, but I would expect that it would be okay, just not blazing fast. As most of these will have been owned by businesses in the past, you may be lucky enough to still have an official warranty, like mine, if they purchased a higher tier, that is. So, this could keep anyone who is afraid of the lack of warranty at ease for the first little bit they own it. So I switched to this for two main reasons. My trusty X250 finally kicked the can due to a broken screen, but it was also feeling a bit long in the tooth, falling apart due to my incessant tinkering and starting to slow down a bit in demanding workload. I also wanted to get something that had a bit more graphics horsepower for playing games when out and about. Some may not like the departure from the traditional ThinkPad design language and style, but I think that it feels like a ThinkPad for the modern age, and I'm very happy with it. The build quality is outstanding, the performance nothing to scoff at, the display is beautiful, and to round it all off, the price point is great. The gripes I have with it aren't any deal breakers for me, them being the poor upgradability and the terrible microSD card slot. So I highly recommend you check out the ThinkPad X395 for your next laptop. Thank you very much for watching, and ciao!